Good evening. First tonight, the St Kilda crisis has deepened as the girl at the heart of the photo scandal made an unwelcome appearance at the team's first training session of the year. The troubled teen finding little support for her cause from Saints fans.
Alone but determined, the 17-year-old took handmade posters to the Saints' new Seaford headquarters to send a message that fans didn't want to hear.
Let it go, all right, and get on with your life.
She needs help, and getting all the attention that she wants isn't going to help her.
You know, I'm not going to listen to some random person when it's like a public area. You know, I have every right to be here.
The girl has won some high-profile support from radio man Darren Hinch.
I believe this is a case of exploitation and a predatory culture that exists amongst grown men who kick and handball for a living.
But there wasn't a friend in sight at Seaford, even though she tweeted plans to be at the team's first training session for the year.
They covered everything up and just lied about things to the media. I just want to sort of tell my side of the story.
The Saints boss invited media in, but the girl was not welcome.
So what will happen if I jump the fence?
Be arrested for trespass.
We think at this point in time that we need to let a little bit of the emotion sort of move away from the situation. We have concerns for the girl, clearly. We have concerns for our players as well.
The teenager claims she's still in touch with at least one player, but seeing the team for the first time since she released the controversial photos brought back bad memories.
Just being spat back out of the loop, you just don't know where to go from there because you've been up so high.
Kate Creedon, 10 News.